For those who can take notes, speaking of a professional modern field, I write for several journals. I write for Strategy Events magazine, I write for IT News, and I write for anyone else who has any experience. Journalist, I'm a super stringer. Of course, what is a super stringer, you ask? A super stringer is a person who's actually paid by certain media to provide certain articles at a certain period of time. For example, I could four or six articles for IT News every week. Not all published. Sometimes, a little bit about me, just to demystify me a little bit. I'm actually a bit like a child empire. I spent 17 years in public service myself, in Washington position of assistant secretary. I've also worked the overseas, been in academia, for the masters. I wish I'd taken more courses in Toastmasters, and I've been editor of several magazines, PC User, and Computer World, and I've written in Australian. Currently, I'm just writing because it's a nice season time in Canberra. And I've also written a book about Bombing censorship in World War II for the University of Queensland Press, for which I do have $5 a week on library use and things like that. So, although it's not available anymore, if you borrow it, you get a dollar every time you borrow it. So, Bombing censorship, it's not as it starts by because it's not available. Let me tell you a little bit about journalism, especially IT journalists. We have a really simple business model, and I do like Jim Sheridan's suggestion about business model, because it's how basically we get it here. It's a really simple business model. One, I get leads. Two, I get content based on those leads. Three, because of an online money these days, I get clicks based on that. And finally, those stories are monetized by Haymarket Media or Australian Business Magazine. And that attracts readers. And hopefully I get more leads based on that. And so it goes around. Where's the model? It's not really exciting, but it's cyclical. And it works about 10 months a year. It's a very good year. As you might imagine, I do journalism because I'm interested in it. I don't do journalism based on my knowledge. My wife does that. She's, in fact, on her accounts payable person most of the time. And so I speak to you, again, in a way to try and mystify and hopefully improve engagement between governments and IT journalists. I obviously don't speak for IT journalists. Most IT journalists are 4 years younger than I am anyway. But I find it useful to speak generally about how journalists operate and how you can upset them, how you can cultivate them, and whether or not we're friends or foe. Frankly, neither, but sometimes it may seem that those two things are beautifully confused. And maybe if there's one story, one thought I want you all to take away is journalists are neither your friend nor your foe. Generally speaking, if you want to ingratiate us, if you want to care for you, like a IT journalist, care anyone who gives us a lick is five stars. No doubt. Also, in return, we always use and we do protect our sources. That goes without saying. We've got some legislation that buttresses that. So, again, I'm not speaking on behalf of anyone, I speak professionally. But if you want a leak, we shall protect you as best we can. We love it when you can foreshadow interesting developments and share it with just me. We love it. That's our theory of the week. It's something that's often observed in government today. We love it if you're willing to go on the record. It's really, I really hate it. And most journalists will sneer and you'll lose the grip with me if you suddenly say, this next session is off the record. Can I also demystify you and say, there's no such thing as off the record. Never, ever assume that if you say something's off the record, it is off the record. It will never be off the record. I will at least remember it. The chances are that into the recorder that's going will remember it as well. And what's worse, why don't you do it? If it's off the record, don't you do it? Please. If you're talking to me as a journalist, do not speak off the record. If you must, indicate that you were perhaps indiscreet. You're going to cover your tracks. Background. And the background. You respect that. Background means it's happening. It's happening in government. We certainly want to put it to you. But if you've got any doubt about anything you're talking with a journalist, don't say it. that's sort of like a negative version. If you make it clear, if you're consistent. We love it if you provoke us. We really like that. We really hate people sucking up to us. Oh, I love that story of yours. You really nailed it. That's a wonderful review. It doesn't help. My editors get really suspicious that I've been catching. Other people think so too. So, much better. Provoke us with an interesting question. Give them clash with us on actual materials. Clashing with us on our point of view is a bit more interesting. But if we got the facts wrong, that's simply, stupid. We didn't do our sums right. We'd like to get it right. And it's the job of any journalist to get the facts right. Suggest interesting questions, please. More generally, news releases. We do like news releases. It's not true that news releases die. Most journalists will read news releases. Most editors will read news releases. If we don't use the news release, it's because it wasn't relevant, we didn't understand it, or it just wasn't that interesting. But we do read your news releases. So, this is not just wanting to put you off putting out news releases. A lot of bullshit about that, especially from social media. News releases are very good, it's not relevant. News releases also give us something to work with, especially if you've got a phone number follower. Most of all, journalists love to be taught. Demonstrate what you're doing. Invite us to an event. Tell us what you're doing. Explain. Most of the time, we aren't really, even in the IT field, we deal with lots of products. With very few exceptions, we write very few product stories. I don't think I've ever written, I think I once wrote a story about that. It's not a true way. So, we're not really interested in, on the whole, in most government programs. We are interested in what they're doing, how they might affect our leadership. So that's how you colour it. And finally, because I'm going to a chair of this here, we love RSS feeds and we love Twitter. It's terrific. It's the next best thing to a news release is an RSS feed. And any agency, we really have a hard time with agencies that don't have RSS feeds. There's a lot of technology we use to get over that. It's not a lot of fun. And often gives me dumb needs. But an RSS feed suggests to me that this is. And the journalists will respect that. For a lot of reasons. One is that a lot of this competition will also be following that RSS feed. And more than that, it gives us an idea about what's happening. We may not write about it, but we get a much better idea about what's happening. And a flavour of what's around. Now, what pisses it off? Asking whether we cut your news release. It's a good way to piss all journalists off. So if you want to signal this is the end of a beautiful relationship, ask whether we use your news release. If you really want to piss us off, ask us when we're going to write a story about your news release. Another way is getting upset when you don't follow the tenor of your news release. We only used some reference in the eighth paragraph to write about. That's just the way it goes. There's this magic thing called newsworthy, and there's a lot of things that are happening that are very important but are not newsworthy. What's the definition of newsworthy? It's a bit of food, but it's basically tell me something I didn't know. Yes, and it's a huge big infrastructure story that we've heard that for some time now. We want to hear what's new. We also hate people who retract what they just said after the event. We often get that. We understand it's mainly by politicians, but it's one of the short ways of completely lowering any kind of credibility because journalists talk about journalists. And, I've seen, I can't publish it, obviously, but there are people around town, people in industries, whose credibility dropped. Fantastically when they did that. So don't ever retract. You might have to apologise, you might clarify, but don't retract. It's very silly. If you think you've been misquoted, that's a slightly different issue. We hate being referred to press officers that don't respond. We understand that most government agencies have a rule that it's best to have professionals in charge, and we understand that. In fact, I like that. I get to know the PR units of most of the agencies I deal with, and we get on extremely well. The way I do it, I don't know how others do it, but in Canberra, I just simply send an email invite for comment about some issue. Nine times out of ten, it works extremely well. Occasionally, they respond, but at least we can say we sought to contact the agency on the issue. We hate it when you're very excited about a project, but you don't tell us any facts. It's pointless. We've got nothing to worry about. Most journalism is about facts. Not about impressions or change, but being upbeat. It's one of the hardest things to get through to people, that if I don't have any facts, all I can say is something really exciting.